Alright guys, welcome back to another segment. You know the way we normally do it. I'm always here to give you guys updates that concerns Chelsea and Chelsea alone. My name is Peters. Alright, a lot is on my table for me to dish it out for you guys so that you guys can deliberate on it and also share your own comments concerning everything I'm going to be talking about on the comment section. Alright, we have Loftus Cheek. Loftus Cheek will soon be leaving Chelsea this summer because AC Milan are keen on signing that guy this summer, which I'm going to be sharing my source of my information with you guys. And also, OGC Nice are set to sign Graham Potter as their new coach, which I'm going to be talking about it. I know you guys are not happy to hear that one, but I will still turn and on a coach, and I got no way to happen to run to. Then, a big congratulations to Man City yesterday for beating Real Madrid. Real Madrid will trash us, will show us paper for Champions League. At least they tried. They did that one for us. You understand? But this weekend, we go see as you go be. And also, Pochettino is working hard to see if he can bring, if he can work with Romelu Lukaku as his number nine, but I don't think that would be possible because Chelsea are still going to sign a new number nine, which he is aware of it. He knows that Chelsea will need a new number nine, whether he likes it or not. But that one, no mistake, Lukaku no go come back from loan, no go come back. But if Inter Milan are serious to sign him permanently, no problem. They should bring the money. We'll give it to them permanently on a permanent deal. But before I go into the news in details, please kindly like this video, share, and most importantly, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because on this channel I only give you updates that concerns Chelsea and Chelsea alone. My name is Peters. All right, I will start with Loftus Cheek. I'll start with Robin Loftus Cheek. Yes, according to PYS, they see that Chelsea are close to their first sale. AC Milan are in advanced talk to sign Robin Loftus Cheek. I know that everybody will be happy to hear this one. You understand? But I don't feel for him, Sha. I don't feel for him, but I know that he's a good one. He should go. We have tried for him, and he has also tried for the club. You understand? But the only thing they vest me for behind, they be say, you know, one just improve. He just don't want to be improve in his skills and also in his career. He don't want to improve. He just like that level he is. You understand? That level when they just like him. He don't want just improve. But I'm surprised that AC Milan are really serious in signing him, you understand? Because already talk have resumed to see if they can bring in Loftus Cheek to the Italian league, you understand? And it's not going to be a bad one for them. Loftus Cheek has been one player right from the academy down to the main team. He has really, really tried, and we too have tried for him by giving him trophies. You understand? So as for Loftus Cheek, no problem. At least one don't they go now. Remaining some way on our list we want to say. But I'll still be saying it irrespective of the fact that you are offloading some players. We should also be careful of some players that we are offloading. You understand? We should not go and offload the one that will affect us. Just like when I saw that the ones that some bloggers published, I saw Koulibaly on that list. I was like, no, now. Even though they want to sell players, not Koulibaly. You understand? I saw Cucurella. I know that some fans don't like Cucurella. Some Chelsea fans want, in short, 80% of Chelsea fans want Cucurella out of the club, but let's tell ourselves the truth. The guy is trying his best. He's picking form gradually. You understand? He's trying his best. So for me, I would say that give those players time. Give them time. Maybe for next season, start slaughtering them back and front if they misbehave. You understand? I just believe that just because of the team is not on a solid state and is not on a good sale this season, that is why they are all at this level. But it was still the same Cucurella that holds Chelsea's defense close, even down to the midfield against Borussia Dortmund, and won man of the match. You understand? So give them some time. Koulibaly too is a very good defender. He's a very, very good defender. Leave all this thing with the toss and they shake. Fine. And also when get where he go reach to get some matches where he go face like this, they shake. But at least out of 10 matches, Koulibaly go hold 7 well for you as a defender. You understand? Irrespective of the fact that some of us don't like him. But it was one player when we signed him. I know the way Chelsea fans are agitating online. We are saying, yes, we don't bring Rudiger replacement. This guy is coming to replace Rudiger. He will do well. Ah, this, that. He has called John Terry to wear number 6. Hey, he's going to do this. No. No, he's good. He's still a good defender. I know some people say the age, leave age too. He's still a good defender. You understand? As for defending side, leave Chelsea. Chelsea get defenders. Now just people, person will just coordinate them, put them in order, put them in the right track, put them in the right face. Say, I do this, you do this, you do this. Finish. They have good defenders. You understand? So that is it. Then I talked about Graham Potter. You understand? I talked about Graham Potter, which I'm going to share the information with you guys. According to PYA, I say that former Chelsea manager Graham Potter has had two meetings about becoming the new manager of OGC Nice. And this OGC Nice is owned by Sir James Ratcliffe. That means he has had a meeting with this Cliff two consecutive times, you understand. So OGC now is want to sign Graham Potter as their new manager, and I guess this Sir Jim Ratcliffe is the same person that is bidding to buy Man U. I guess yes, it's the same person. So let's just see how that Graham Potter did pull through for him, because if he pull through for him, is a good one, because Nadia is supposed to start from self. Men go there, go coach there. Because he showed me, if to say put up in still day Brighton, I don't think Brighton will be at this position or at this level in football. I don't know for you guys, though. You can still come to the comment section and argue it, no problem. But I don't think Brighton will still be at this same level in football if Potter was still there as their manager. According to Vinks, he said that Chelsea are planning to include Mateo Kovacic in a straight swap deal for Inter Milan and Jay Onana. I don't know how true is this information, though, because normally the one that we have been hearing about Kovacic is that Bayern Munich and Man City are planning on signing him on a permanent deal to their club. But this one of talking about swap deal for Andre Onana, I don't really know how true this information is, but I still have to come out and share it with you guys, you understand? But if they are to swap a player for Andre Onana, and they will still pay, because don't think Kovacic, swapping Kovacic for Andre Onana, that a club has already placed on him on £40 million, is not going to be that easy, you understand? So noticing that Kovacic not be Inter Milan problem. You get me? But if Chelsea really do their business very well, I guess they will get Onana. But if Onana doesn't work out for them, like I said before, this guy, Martinez, did ya. That Aston Villa goalkeeper, he did ya. Made them sign him. You understand? Since they don't want to extend Eduardo Mendy's contract, and also Kepa is not sure of being in that post next season as the number one goalkeeper, they should just sign that Martinez in Aston Villa if Onana's deal won't pull through for them. Then I talked about Romelu Lukaku, which I'm going to share it with you guys here. Then breaking news on PYA, he said that Mauricio Pochettino is open to working with Romelu Lukaku. Talk are delayed until after the UEFA Champions League. Well, I don't know for that one. No, like I said, anything that concerns Lukaku, I would say they should just give Lukaku to Inter Milan on a permanent deal, because that guy coming back to Chelsea is not going to be committed. He's not going to be focused on doing his thing in Chelsea, irrespective of the coach that is coming in. Leave this one that Pochettino say want to work with it. We know say we go see signing striker. You understand? We go see signing striker. The striker will be the even see say. For free sign, he don't get a match ban, which is Ivan Toney, which I know that Chelsea would have shake their body a little to see if they can bring in that guy. But right now, you see this Lukaku, they should leave him in Inter. If he's coming back, he's not going to perform well, just like the way he's performing in Inter. As for Victor Osimhen too, well, now business, I know say things will happen on the last day of transfer, just like the way it happened for Enzo Fernandez. I'll see before the man and be looking how things will go. You understand? For now, I can't tell about that Victor Osimhen again. The only thing I can tell for now is that Victor Osimhen is just celebrating his win. And then, as for Man City, congratulations to them. They tried very well yesterday, beating these guys 4-0 Real Madrid. They just disgraced them, put them for grand. And I wait to fit Madrid, the way they disgrace us, now so they carry disgrace them too. Then, these people, the Chelsea female team beat West Ham. Was it 4-0? 4-0 and they are the one topping the league right now. I just hope it continues like that so that they can also win the league. So guys, that will be all for now. Do it to like the video, share and drop your comments, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because on this channel I only give you updates that concerns Chelsea and Chelsea alone. My name is Peters.